How do you know what to measure for your staff members, your team members? This one's a tricky one, and it's one that very, very, very few business owners actually can give me an answer for, which is kind of like driving around in your car without a fuel gauge or a speedo. How do you know where you're going, how fast you're going, how much further you can keep going? And it's a bit of a frustrating and a scary thing for business owners. So the easiest way to work this one out is to go, well, pick a team member. And I do this whenever I start with new clients. It's so important. And even big businesses who you think they would be able to answer this one pretty quick don't have a clue. And the question is, what is the number one thing you are paid for? And usually you'll get a bunch of fluffy type answers like, oh, customer satisfaction or meeting deadlines or whatever. But the thing is, Peter Drucker said, if you can't measure it, you can't manage it. And to measure, there are two factors. It's a bit loud, that one. You have to have a number, or you have to have what I call a binary condition, which is either a yes or a no. Anything else is fluffy and open to interpretation. And what's probably even more astounding is, well, not so much more astounding, but when you go and ask a team member what's the number one thing that they are paid for, they don't know either. So if the boss doesn't know and the team member doesn't know, then it kind of makes it really hard to manage that. So drilling down on that number is really, really important. So I'm going to post a comment down below. Some of you guys have got this when you bought the book. I offered it as an additional support to the book. You got it at a special price. So I'm going to put it back up. I'll put it in the comment section. If you don't know how to measure team performance, if you don't know what sort of numbers to even start with, this tool has got a bunch of all the different things that you need to look at for all the different areas in the business and all the different positions. It just makes it so much easier. So have a look down the comments. If it's something that you're looking for, jump on and get it. Buy it, download it, use it in your business. You can book a time with me and I can help you walk it through. Make sure you get all the right numbers in the right places. So now, you don't have to have a whole bunch of different things that you're measuring. You might only be measuring one thing. I mean, the 80-20 rule is probably going to kick in at some stage and you'll see what's going on. Okay, Ben, how are you today, mate? Make sure that you go through and make sure that you're clear on what your team measurement is, and that your staff member, your team member, is also clear on what that measure is, and it's going to make your life a whole bunch easier. So have a great day and enjoy the rest of your weekend.